My art certainly has a rational framework. I have this desire to know. Everything begins with but why. Why does this work? And why? Why doesn't that work? And also with a wonder. A wonder if I apply this. Would it be better? Would it be more interesting and have more meaning? So how? How can we do this? A good painter has to paint two principal things. That's to say, man and the intention of his mind. The first is easy and the second difficult, because that latter has to be represented through gestures and movements of the limbs. In Aberdeen, I was taught how to draw. Drawing is like a sport, you need to do it every day. Practice and train your hand-eye coordination. It keeps the senses sharp and fine-tuned. And drawing from life is the best. Proportion is key to figurative drawing. To an extent, it doesn't matter what mark you make, as long as it's in the right place. Though every mark has to be fully considered, from beginning to end. It may start sharp and thin and might end soft and broad, all within one stroke. So within one mark, not only the pressure of the pencil on the paper changes, but also its angle with the paper. Quality marks that are varied, but also unique in describing something. How innovative can you be in your mark making? How can you make sure that people not only recognize what it is, but also that it was you that drew it? How much do you need to draw? What can you omit? How do you keep the eye interested? I often call it finding flow when I feel myself around the figure, how one limb flows into another, from one end of the drawing into the next, aiming for the most minimal mark, yet one that is apt, beautiful and unique, all at the same time in what it describes. How can you stylize your subject? Pencil drawings are so honest, have a beckoning intimacy and simple beauty. The tool I use for drawing in ink is a calligraphy pen. It has a large reservoir that holds the ink, Japanese ink. This ink and this tool both allow you to draw for longer without interrupting the flow of your gesture and thus the energy of your mark making. The tool also enables you a great variety of marks, even without one stroke or gesture. My studio is down near the harbour of Aberdeen in the loft of an old gasworks building. I went down to the docks one day to do some sketching, and after that I kept returning. I love it when a landscape evolves as you draw or things enter the composition. Picking these things up in a sketch can sometimes surprisingly develop and strengthen a composition one not thought of so far. The hustle and the bustle. From Aberdeen Harbour, I went on to Aberdeen Heliport. Dressed in my high-fist safety vest and hard hat and walking into one of the gigantic hangars filled with perilously stripped helicopter bodies, rotor heads, gearboxes, engines and rotor blades, I did not know where to start first. In short time I was handling the tools and ducking swinging gearboxes flying past me while I was drawing, which I'm probably not really allowed to disclose for health and safety reasons. Then onwards to Speyside, and it's risky. Coopers dancing around each other and their bowels, busy shaping and shaping and pounding, a core component of a global market, yet driven on skilled labour using traditional tools and handcrafted methods. It was gold to me. In the Heliport and Whiskey series, I made an effort to change the drawing angle by looking down on the runway from a nearby building, positioning myself on top of a helicopter or on a viewing platform or bench at the Cooperage. I'm interested not only who's the life and soul of the party, but the quiet person at the back, absorbed in their thoughts and daily business. It's a far more natural way to capture someone, and far more interesting to me, as it happens every day. Having lived in Scotland for over a decade, my picture postcard Scotland is a rough around the edges portrayal. A Scotland absorbed in work and play, and at one with its environment. I see beauty in that. Art for me appeals to an emotive response, is engulfing, resonates quietly or loudly, in all sorts of ways. It's a one-to-one relation, an intimate one, and makes you think. Whether it's dance, music, paintings or installation, art that survives the test of time, needs originality, its own personality, and art that made an impression on me, I carry with me and remember. And that's what I would battle for and strive in my own work. Thank you.
one. Any more questions?